how to use this fucking camera.
So it's been a little while since I've uploaded to YouTube. This period of time is probably the biggest gap in uploads that I've had since I started back in November last year. It's all been for good reason. There's been a lot of things happening in the last couple of weeks. Here's what we've been up to. Firstly, earlier in the month, we went to Sydney for a week, so we were away for a week.
Thanks.
Just leave him there?
We're going to Sydney. We're going fucking an hour away. We're not going very far. We're doing Tony Robbins this weekend. Okay, perfect. Thank you. See you soon. Bye bye. Babe, our ride's here. Mum's here to take us to the airport. Good old Martha.
Are you ready?
Can I talk to you?
Yeah.
Off camera?
You can tell the vlog. Share it with the class.
No, I can't.
I can see why Robin didn't want to share what she had to say on the... Hey, could you get my key out?
What key?
The key to lock the door.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Unleash your power then. What are you hoping to get from it?
More growth, more education to teach others.
I concur. See, part of the reason that I like to go to seminars so much is that you learn different things, the different ways that people teach the same message, basically, but different ways they teach it. And then I can sort of change that into my own, put my own touch in it, and then teach people and empower people. But this particular event's called Unleash the Power Within. It's about personal empowerment, which is a lot of what I'm about, a lot of what I teach my students through Infinite Prosperity and through my coaching. So anything that I can get to help people empower themselves, and then I can pass on, it's a benefit for me. It's a benefit for our students too. It's gonna be a good gig. UPW was all right. I made a full review of my opinion on Unleash the Power Within here on my second YouTube channel. The second YouTube channel, by the way, is all my Snapchat uploads. So when I do a Snapchat story, if it's a particularly good one or an important one, I export it and upload it to that channel there. Go and watch that. It's a more detailed review. In summary, UPW with Tony Robbins. When Tony was on the stage, it was brilliant. The content that he had was brilliant. When he went out into the audience and plucked people out of the crowd, like what you saw in the Netflix documentary, it was brilliant. He's brilliant. The issue with UPW, at least the one that we attended earlier in the month, is that he was only there for 2 of the 4 days. That's crazy. 2 of the other days, there was either someone else on stage or there was videos of Tony Robbins talking, which they were on YouTube. We could have just downloaded them for free. In fact, on the second night, we went home early because there was 5,000 people sitting there watching videos of Tony Robbins at a Tony Robbins conference. Pfft, crazy. I don't know how he gets away with doing that, but he does it. People didn't seem to care that much. For me, I thought that was a bit crazy. I mean, if I ever run seminars, I tell you what, and I'm selling a 4-day seminar with me, I won't be bailing 2 of the days. That makes sense. But he's Tony Robbins, so he can fucking just about get away with anything, it seems. The second thing that's been taking up all my time this month is this car that I've been looking at buying. What the fuck date is it today? It's 3 weeks ago. On the 1st of September, I woke up, it was a Wednesday, and I had this phenomenal idea that I needed to buy a new car. For whatever reason, I got the impulse, I looked it up, I went into, booked a meeting in the showroom, I went there, I had a chat. If I want to do a factory order, there's gonna be a 12-month waiting list, or an 8-month if you sort of threatened to buy another model. But essentially there was a 12-month waiting list. But there was one sitting there in the showroom, fully optioned, brand new, at a ridiculous price. I was basically stealing it. So we got the ball was in motion, and I signed the contract. A day later I put the deposit down, and it was all happening. Here's the issue. I've been spending my time on getting the finance for the freaking thing. And for full disclosure, no one wants to give me money to buy it. No one wants to give me money because my finances are not regular. Because the way I make money in the eyes of financiers isn't secure enough for them. They prefer job income. High paying job income is what a financier prefers. So my particular income is, in their opinion, is crazy. And most people who do what I do don't make money, so that from their point of view, which is, I get it, they're risk managers, they don't want to give me, no one wants to give me money. On top of that, because I have a very, very good accountant at the moment, she splits my income amongst trusts, so Lewis Mocker as an individual doesn't make much. He doesn't make much money. So when I go and say, hey, I want this loan to get this car, they're like, you don't make much money. We can't give you the, we can't give you the finance for that. So serviceability as a general whole is fine, but we have to find a financier who's willing to look at all the income and aggregate it. They're not interested in looking at my bank statements. I have one spendings account where all my spendable income comes into. No one wants to look at that. They need to have it in the form of a tax lodge entity that they can send the loan to. Anyway, the thing with that is that I'm not infatuated with the outcome of whatever happens. If it happens, I get the car, brilliant. It's a phenomenal car. I can't wait to get the car. If it doesn't happen and that I don't get the, go and get the finance, it's just, I'm not meant to have that particular car at this particular time. I don't really care, I'm not attached to the outcome of it. In Lesson 8 of Infinite Prosperity, I teach you guys how to neutralize an infatuation with some particular thing, whether that be a girl or a relationship or a goal or a car or a house or a particular lifestyle. Neutralizing your infatuations makes you smarter. The thing with this particular finance thing is if I was infatuated with getting that car, I could have done some dumb shit to get the car. One thing I could do is finance it in one of my companies. The company, as a single entity, has enough to service the loan. I could just do it. The thing in Australia is we have luxury car tax. It's 33%. That's why our cars are so expensive here in Australia. But on top of that, we have a lot of GST limits, which means if I buy the car, I can claim back some of the GST, but when I go and sell it, I'm be charged GST at the back end. So if I go and buy it and finance it in the company name, by the time I sell it in 3 or 4 years' time, I'm literally be spending $30,000 to $40,000 more just because I couldn't be patient enough to get the finance in my own name. That would be crazy, and if I was infatuated with the idea of it, I'd go and do it. Lesson of the day, don't infatuate with anything. Don't become attached to the outcome of anything. There's benefits and there's drawbacks to every single thing that happens to you in your life. If that never comes through, it doesn't matter to me. Don't get too attached to the outcome of things. Is the mini lesson of this video. And finally, the third thing that's been keeping me busy is that the other day, about probably 2 days after I got back from Sydney from Tony Robbins, I made a Snapchat story about my coaching thing that I do. I do coaching sort of privately. I'm not gonna mention it, I'm not gonna link it here because it's full. I can't take on any more people. But I mentioned it on Snapchat and all my slots just filled out. And it's not cheap, I do an hourly session, but I spend about 3 hours on each case. And every single day already with a calendar that's full, squeezing another 3 hours into there every single day is not possible for me right now. So that's been keeping me busy, 3 hours extra a day doing these coaching calls. They've been really, really, really awesome. I love it. I'm gonna try and figure out a way because I would like to scale that up. I love teaching. And one-on-one is a medium that I haven't done for the last 4 years until earlier this year when I started doing it. I love it. It's the best. Being able to connect with people and go through their particular case study, love that shit. It's just not sustainable right now for me to scale that up. So I'm gonna have to sort of figure out something to, that can, anyway, you get the idea. That's what I've been doing.